I'm Kathavachak and welcome to the realm of Katha. Today's Katha dates back to Treta Yuga and is about a great king from Ishvaku dynasty, the King Ambarish. King Ambarish was a staunch devotee of Lord Vishnu and is considered as protector of the truth. One day, King Ambarish was conducting a holy ritual which was called Dwadashi Yagya. Now, in this ritual, he was supposed to have a fast for one day and then break open his fast on the day of Dwadashi. Just as he was about to break his fast, suddenly Rishi Durvasa turned up in front of him. King Ambarish was very much elated. He welcomed Rishi Durvasa with all the pomp and show, and he was very much devoted to him. King Ambarish invited Rishi Durvasa as chief guest of his yagya. Now Rishi Durvasa gladly accepted, but he put up a condition. He said that I still need to bathe, so let me just go to river Yamuna. I'll take a bath and then you can break open your fast. And King Ambarish agreed to it. Now Rishi Durvasa went away to bathe in Yamuna and people started waiting for him. They waited and waited for hours at the end, but there was no sign of Rishi Durvasa. After some time, everyone started getting worried. The ritual was dependent on a specific timeline. If the fast was not opened before that timeline, there would be very bad omens which would happen in the kingdom. So everyone called up King Ambarish and suggested to him that he should break open his fast by drinking just one sip of water. Now, one sip of water would not actually demean Rishi Durvasa also, and it would break his fast also, which would prevent the Dwadashi Yag from getting bad. King Ambarish agreed to the suggestion. As soon as he took one sip of water, suddenly Rishi Durvasa appeared in front of everyone and started shouting. He was really, really angry and he said to King Ambarish, "You couldn't even wait for me for even 1 minute. You are no bearer of truth, let me tell you. Everyone says that you protect the truth and you follow the truth, but you are not. You're not doing that. And you don't even have the decency to respect your elders and to respect your chief guests. So let me just give you the lesson of your life." And he immediately plucked one strand of his hair and turned it into a discus and sent it towards King Ambarish. Everyone was scared for King Ambarish's life because everyone knew that no one can protect King Ambarish from Rishi Durvasa's wrath. Lo and behold, there was a huge sound in the sky and suddenly everyone saw Sudarshan discus flying towards the discus sent by Rishi Durvasa. Sudarshan discus first destroyed another discus and then started flying towards Rishi Durvasa. Durvasa was scared for his life and started running away. He ran here and there, he ran to the topmost of mountains, he ran through the ocean, he tried going everywhere, but he couldn't protect himself. Then he went to Lord Brahma and prayed for his rescue. Lord Brahma told him that, "I cannot protect you. You did something that you shouldn't have. So now nobody can protect you. You can try going to Lord Shiv, but I don't think even he can do that." So now Rishi Durvasa ran towards Mountain Kailash and went to Lord Shiv to pray for his life. Even Lord Shiv denied him and said, "See, there was something really bad that you did. You didn't respect somebody's yagya and you didn't respect their rituals. So it was not their fault, it was yours. So nobody can protect you. You can try going to Lord Vishnu who sent the Sudarshan Chakra, but I cannot promise your life." So now Rishi Durvasa went to Lord Vishnu and finally prayed to him. So Lord Vishnu told him, "Dear Rishi Durvasa, I respect you a lot and everybody respects you a lot. But it doesn't mean that you misuse your respect and you misuse your enchantments and your good deeds. King Ambarish was only doing his duty and he waited diligently for you, but you delayed the process. And you know that rituals, the process has to be followed in the rituals. So it was your fault. And even I cannot protect you now. You can try going to King Ambarish and I think only he can protect you if he wants." So now Rishi Durvasa went back to King Ambarish and with folded hands requested him to save his life. King Ambarish was flabbergasted to see Rishi Durvasa's condition and he immediately stepped in front of him and in front of Sudarshan Discus and prayed with folded hands. "Dear Sudarshan Discus, please save Rishi Durvasa. Please don't harm him. It's my fault and I should have already seen you coming. So please don't harm him. Please go back to Lord Vishnu. So Darshan Discus came towards King Ambarish and it took one circle around him and then went back to Lord Vishnu. Rishi Durvasa was relieved out of his senses. He then said to King Ambarish, "Dear King Ambarish, it was completely my fault. I should have respected your rituals. I should have respected what you were doing. You were only doing your duties and I couldn't see that in because I had my vanity in front of me. But now I think I have seen the truth. I have seen the reality of situations. So now I think I'll be your friend for the lifetime." So King Ambarish folded his hands in front of Rishi Durvasa and gave him the arms that he deserved and completed his ritual. So this was today's katha. There is one very important lesson that we learn from this katha. It doesn't matter however great a position of power we may reach, we should always be responsible and humble, and we should always follow the truth. In this story as well, King Ambarish followed the truth. And King Durvasa, though he was respected all around the universe, despite that he misused his power. So we should always, always follow our power with the responsibility. We'll get back to you with another story next time. Until then,